Welcome to this session on 3.5 PV technology. In this video, we will discuss the material properties of semiconductors used for this technology. In this video, you will learn what the 3.5 PV technology exactly is and how it's different from other solar cell technologies. We will then discuss the structural properties of 3.5 semiconductors. In the next video, we will look into the electrical and optical properties of 3.5 materials. The 3.5 PV technology, as the name implies, utilizes elements of the 3A group and the 5A group in the periodic table of elements. As you might recall, group 3 elements have 3 electrons in their outer valence shell, and therefore group 5 elements have 5 valence electrons. One of the most common 3.5 absorber materials is formed by bonding the group 3 material gallium with the group 5 material arsenic. Several such combinations are possible, however, and many different 3.5 alloys are used as an absorbing material by the PV industry. Examples include gallium phosphide, indium phosphide, indium arsenide, gallium indium arsenide, gallium indium phosphide, aluminium gallium indium arsenide, and aluminium gallium indium phosphide. An important question for the 3.5 technology is how abundant are the 3 and the 5 elements? As discussed at the start of this course, of these 5 elements, only aluminium and phosphorus are relatively abundant in nature. Gallium, arsenide and germanium are not rare or precious metals, but they are much less abundant than silicon. Indium is rare and in high demand. In addition, the processing methods to deposit high-quality 3.5 alloys are relatively expensive. As a result, 3.5 materials like gallium arsenide are very expensive materials in reference to other PV materials like silicon. Moreover, arsenic is highly toxic. So, why do researchers still pursue these 3.5 technologies? The answer to this question can be found in the NREL chart for best research cell efficiencies. The multi-junction technology based on 3.5 absorber materials are indicated here in purple. As we can see, the solar cells with 3.5 absorbers strongly outperform the other PV technologies. The current record triple junction solar cell without light concentration developed by Sharp has an efficiency of 37.9%. The record 4 junction solar cell with light concentration is developed by Fraunhofer ESE and has an efficiency of 46%. 3.5 semiconductor materials are in principle the most ideal materials for PV applications. As I will discuss in the coming videos, they are direct bandgap materials, have excellent electrical properties and can approach the Shockley-Quiescent limit as both Auger and Shockley-Rieth-Hull recombination can be eliminated under standard test conditions. This makes the 3.5 PV technology an attractive option for a niche where a very high power output per unit area is crucial. The high-cost, high-performance 3.5 technology is therefore primarily used for space applications and concentrator photovoltaics. As example, this picture shows a solar panel array mounted on the International Space Station. For such applications, the matrix of modules with high efficiency in combination with lightweight are the most important. The inset shows a concentrator PV device where lenses are used to focus the sunlight on a very small solar cell. A tracking system is used to follow the sun through the day. We will discuss concentrator PV and PV use for space exploration later this section. We will now first focus on the structural properties of the 3.5 semiconductor materials. Let us begin with a comparison between the crystal structure of gallium arsenide and silicon. As you may notice from the animation, both gallium arsenide and silicon lattice have a similar tetrahedral structure. The major difference between the two, however, is that silicon is a pure diamond cubic crystalline structure based on solid element silicon, whereas gallium arsenide is a crystalline structure in which every gallium atom is neighboring 4 arsenic atoms, and the other way around, every arsenic atom is neighboring 4 gallium atoms. The gallium arsenide lattice structure is a so-called zinc blend crystal lattice structure. Important to note is that both gallium and arsenide are more than twice as heavy as silicon, and therefore the density of a cubic cell of gallium arsenide is more than twice as heavy as a cubic cell of crystalline silicon. This means that a gallium arsenide wafer having the same dimensions and thickness as a silicon wafer will weigh almost 4 times as much as the silicon wafer. In addition, the lattice constant is different. The lattice constant denotes the edge length of a cubic cell and is around 20 picometers greater in gallium arsenide in reference to silicon. Interestingly, the lattice constant of gallium arsenide is very close to that of germanium. Most 3-5 alloys have different lattice constants. As we will discuss later, the lattice constants become very important if you start processing multi-junction solar cells that are based on different combinations of 3-5 materials for each junction. In summary, in this video you learned about different elements used to create 3-5 absorber layers. Since most of these elements are relatively rare and processing is relatively expensive, 3-5 semiconductors are very expensive. A large advantage of the 3-5 technology is that it strongly outperforms the other PV technologies, which makes it the best choice for applications that require a high output power density, such as space exploration and concentrator PV. We also learned that a unit cell of gallium arsenide is denser and longer than a unit cell of crystalline silicon, and these structural properties impact the operation of 3-5 solar cells. In the next video, we will take a look at the electrical and optical properties of the 3-5 materials.